full body tracking in VR. We all want it, but can't afford it. That's why today, after a ton of people have asked me about how I got full body tracking to work in my Blade and Sorcery video, that I am going to teach you how I did it using Tony Stark's box of scraps. This is going to be a really short tutorial video about how to get the setup for PC VR, and just to warn you guys, not many games use full body tracking. But it is pretty cool, you can do motion capture as well, this isn't just limited to VR, and there probably are just a ton more uses out there that I haven't run into yet. But anyways, let's just get straight into this. The first things that you're going to need are 2 Joy-Cons and 3 phones, or 5 phones. Either way, you need a minimum of 5 trackers. You will also need some way to strap the devices onto your body. I used 2 Joy-Con straps, 2 pant pockets, and a fanny pack. Hell, you could probably use tape.
Don't use tape! Do not use tape!
You will need 2 trackers for your feet, 2 for your thighs, and 1 for your chest. I have the best experience by putting my Joy-Cons on my feet, and the rest being phones. If you are using Joy-Cons, you will need Slime VR Wrangler, and everyone will need Slime VR Server. You will also need Steam VR on a VR-capable PC, and a VR headset of any kind. Sadly though, standalone Quest does not support full body tracking. You can use apps like AirLink, Steam Link, or Virtual Desktop and stream from your PC. That works perfectly fine, but you can't run Blade and Sorcery Nomad from your Quest headset and expect it to work with full body tracking. That just doesn't work. The game needs to be on your PC. But with that out of the way, let's simply install all the software that will be used. All the software I will be talking about will have links in the description to download, and on top of that, all of it is free. So first things you're gonna need, it's gonna be Steam VR, which if you are watching this video, I am assuming you already have, but if not, this is how you play VR games on PC using Steam, so just download that. It's a click of a button. The second thing you're going to need is Slime VR Wrangler. This allows you to connect your Joy-Cons to your PC as VR trackers instead of just a typical Bluetooth controller. You can easily get this from their GitHub, link in the description, but we don't need to open it yet, so just install it, we will open it later. The third thing you will need is Slime VR itself, which you can simply get from the GitHub with the link in the description. You're going to follow all the instructions that the setup tells you to do, and if it asks for you to set up tracking, just press the skip button as we will do that later. It may also ask to install a Steam VR plugin. If so, press accept, as this is needed for Steam VR implementation. Now for the phones, I use OOTrack, which basically allows my phone's tracking such as gyro, acceleration, and more to connect to my PC's IP address. This is another thing that we will set up later. And the last thing, which is probably the easiest, is any other VR software you require to run your headset. Virtual Desktop, Steam Link, AirLink, MetaQuest app, whatever the hell you use. Now everything should be installed, but let's set it all up. The first thing is, if you are using Joy-Cons, you will need to open Slime VR Wrangler and allow it any admin permissions it asks for. Then go to your actual Joy-Cons and connect via Bluetooth to your computer. Easiest way to do this is to flip to the black side of the Joy-Con and hold the small sync button until the lights start flashing in a wave pattern. You can then go to your PC and connect them as if you are connecting a typical Bluetooth device. Do this for both Joy-Cons and you will see in Slime VR Wrangler that your 2 Joy-Cons have popped up. This means that your Joy-Cons are set up and ready to go. You will also see some orientation options on each Joy-Con, so rotate them as you see fit, depending on the orientation that you strap them to your body in. Now your Joy-Cons are set up, we will move on to the Slime VR server. This will let you connect all your devices together and will let each device control a portion of the skeleton, aka you. Your Joy-Cons should automatically pop up in the Slime VR server app when they are connected to Wrangler. Here, you will determine which Joy-Con should go on your right foot and which on your left foot. It doesn't really matter. Just keep track of which one is on which foot, as you will now assign them to the correct foot that it is attached to. In Slime VR, simply go to tracker assignment, select 5 trackers, and if you're using more, then just select the amount that you're using, and assign each Joy-Con to the correct foot. You should also see a skeleton in the corner moving its legs around as you move the Joy-Cons. You should do this to test and make sure each Joy-Con is assigned to the correct foot. Now that your Joy-Cons are set up, we will switch to your phones by using OOTrack. OOTrack is very easy to use. All you need is your PC's IP address and a phone that turns on. You can get the IP address from your computer by opening the command prompt and typing in ipconfig. Mine is blurred for security reasons, but I simply put the IPv4 address into the IP address section of OOTrack. You will do this for each phone while also ensuring that you're using the port 6969 or 35903, as OOTrack uses these ports to connect to your computer. Lastly, do the same thing that you did with the Joy-Cons, where you went to tracker assignment and assigned each device to the proper part of your body. Another thing to mention is that you can control the Slime VR trackers in Steam VR VR to an extent of either disabling or changing them around. I never had to deal with this menu as Slime VR properly enabled the right trackers to the right body parts in Steam VR. Now everything is basically ready for use. The installation of Slime VR should automatically install the Steam VR plugin, meaning that all that is left to do is to strap each device to the proper part of your body and try out a game that uses full body tracking. Now it may not work on the first try, this is where you should go back and either adjust your tracker's locations, ensure all the devices are on and properly connected to the PC, and ensure that Slime VR is running and is properly connected to Steam VR. But if I am going to be completely honest, I had a very smooth experience and it all worked on my first try. I was really shocked because I thought it was going to be harder, but it took me 2 hours total and I was done. And that's pretty much it. If you made it to this part of the video with zero issues, then congratulations on having the cheapest full body tracking you will probably see for a long time that is of this quality. Of course, assuming that you already own everything on this list. Just remember though that this is not a perfect setup at all, and you may have to reset your position every now and then. But hey, it's cheap full body tracking, I will not complain. Now you can dive into a game that supports full body tracking to test your suit out, or you can simply try using natural locomotion to implement smaller actions like physically walking in place into titles that don't support body tracking. If you guys do have any issues, then please comment down below, I'll do my best to help out, and also this is the first tutorial I have ever done, so I hope I did a good job, and if not, I am sorry. Thank you all for watching, and I hope this did work for you, I hope this helped you, and I hope this got you what you really wanted with cheap full body tracking. And if I don't release a new video in the next few weeks, then I probably got too immersed with my full body tracking and got sucked into whatever game I was playing.